The following show is being brought to you in part by Body Best Collision Center, Myers Financial, Larbre Automotive, Tina Schoen, Broker Associate, Sotheby's International Realty, and Word Mice. Weinberg Deli, located at 997 Napa Road in Sonoma. And Krista Grant Insurance Services, located at 255 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to KristaGrantInsurance.com. Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. You can contact them at 707-935-2685 or visit them on the web at BroadwayMarketSonoma.com. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street in Sonoma. For more information, you can go to SonomaPaintCenter.com. Sonoma Chevrolet, located at 687 West Napa Street in Sonoma. For more information, you can go to SonomaChevy.com.
Can you feel it? Love is in the air. People, can you hear it? Love is everywhere. People, can you feel it? Love is everywhere.
Live from KSVY Studio B, I'm Stan Pappas, and I'm here tonight with Eddie Duran, who is a jazz guitar player for a couple of years that I know of, and we're going to listen to some of his music. We're going to have a few questions, and Eddie,
yes,
you know, I remember you from the 50s, really, I do, and but I was told that you started your musical career around 1945 after the war with like a little trio. Is that is that correct?
Yes.
Good, because I got it from Mad. It should be right.
My two other brothers and myself loved the King Cole Trio.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And so we started playing like them.
That kind of stuff.
Yeah. And of course, I started at... in the music business, we started at about six.
What?
6 years
the
old.
The age of 6 years old?
Yeah.
Honest to God?
Yes. Oh, yes. Myself, my next brother, and my next brother.
Younger or older?
They were older.
They were older, okay.
But myself and my second brother, he played, he sang, and he played maracas. We did some Latin music.
Mm-hmm.
And I played the guitar. And at that point, the guitar I was using was a, what they call a tenor guitar. It had four strings. And so, my parents, especially my mother and sister, they would make our costumes, these big blouses, you know, that were kind of frilly. And
yeah,
things
yeah,
like
yeah,
that.
The puffy kind of thing.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so, so we played as a duo, and my brothers sang, and he played the maracas.
Did people pay you then when you were 6 years old?
Well, you know, at that time, theaters were having amateur hours.
Okay.
And they were presenting music.
And also, we're talking about we're in San Francisco,
oh,
right,
yeah,
at that time?
Yeah. And so they were, the movie would go off, and then they'd have people performing. You know. And we won quite a few of them, you know.
Wow.
Yeah, so we started... And then also the whole family practically was in music. My sister sang, she was the dancer, and my next older brother, the third brother, would accompany her on guitar. So he was playing guitar, and I got inspired to play guitar.
It's a better world that you played the guitar.
Yeah.
So what do you want to play for us first?
Luis Bonfa wrote the music to this music, to this movie.
Thank you.
there you have it.
Thank you. That was, you know, right. We've had five or six of these shows that we've showed on SVTV. Uh-huh. You just brought it up a couple notches. I'm not taking anything away from any of the other people. Well, I can because I was one of them, but, you know, that was fabulous. I got a couple more questions for
yes.
you. Do you remember a guy in San Francisco, and Betty knows him, by the name of Enrico Banducci?
Oh, yes. I knew him very well.
I bet you did, yeah. And that was at the Hungry Eye, right?
At the Hungry Eye, yes.
And what did you do there?
Well, myself and bass player, Dean Riley.
Dean Riley?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And the pianist, Don Asher, who was also a writer. I'll tell you about him later. So we became the house trio. And the Banducci was also a musician. He played violin.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes. And at times, you know, before we'd start or during the breaks, he'd go into his office and you could hear him playing his violin. So he was really something. And he loved, of course, musicians, and we were treated royally because he had respect for musicians, you know. And it was really great. And so I played at one point. Well, we got to play behind some of the acts, not all of them. But one of them was Barbara Streisand.
That was very early in her career.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Did she make her first album by then? Probably not.
Oh, no. I think she might have. I think she did make
the
first
album. I had that one.
So we played. She brought in her own conductor. So I played behind her, and we hired a drummer, and Dean was playing bass, and it was great, you know, just watching her sing, you know, and played sometimes behind some of the comedians, you know. Well, what's it, the
Mort Saul, maybe?
Oh yeah, Mort Saul, yeah. Of course. And then there was the Woody Allen.
Woody Allen. How about Jonathan Winters?
Jonathan Winters.
He was there too,
wasn't
he?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
That was that period when he decided to climb the mast on the Belclutha ship at one point.
he was nuts, wasn't he? Yeah, nuts, really, certifiably.
Oh, yeah.
Funny, though.
So there were a lot of stories, you know. At one point, when money got tight, you know, well, business wasn't as good as usual, as it usually was, you know. But one of the things was that when the came to get paid, we'd all kind of rush down to the bank to make sure that there was enough there.
Make sure the check
was Yeah, but we usually made it. But there were great little incidents.
You got there like bright and early the next morning, right?
Yeah,
sure.
It was really, oh, God, yes.
That's great.
Yeah.
And then after that, or maybe during that, there was a club that I used to go to, and I was a little bit underage at that time. It was called the Black Hawk.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Yeah, and you played there.
Yeah, that was later on. Yeah.
It was later on, and was like Cal Jader one of those guys?
Well, Cal was there. Well, there were a lot of great players that came through there, Cal. And, I called Art Tatum.
Art Tatum.
Was one. Yeah, oh, God, yeah. That was really good. It was the jazz club at the time.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, all right, look, what are you going to play for us now?
My Romance.
My Romance. Thank you. That was great. That was really great.
Thank you.
I've got it. My next question has only got three words to it, but I'm sure you'll talk more about it than this three words, and that's called the Venetian Room.
Oh, the Venetian, yep.
But, I know you played there.
Oh, yeah. Quite a few gigs there. I got to play behind, with Peggy Lee.
Peggy Lee.
Yeah. Now, Peggy.
I had heard that she didn't have any other guitar player but you.
Well, no.
No?
But I think at that point.
Not too many, though.
But, of course, in L.A., there were a lot of great
But the
players.
Venetian Room, you
yeah.
know.
But when she came, she asked me to play.
Yeah.
And we had, pianist. Might have been, at this point I can't remember.
Well, sure.
But she brought her own pianist and bass player.
Oh, she did?
Yeah.
Okay. And she had the Ernie Hexter band also, right?
Yeah, but we didn't use the big band.
Oh, you didn't?
No, it's just a
a little trio?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that must have been fabulous.
And she liked guitar players because her husband, I don't think he was alive by that time, but Dave Barber was a guitarist.
That's right, and they wrote a lot of music together.
Yeah. Oh, definitely.
Yes, they did. Yeah, so did they do Mañana?
No, but she did Fever.
Oh, Fever.
That was one of her.
That was the big one.
Yeah.
That was the biggest one,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
Right.
She was a nice person.
Well, I could remember going to the Venetian Room as a young guy. I think the first group I ever saw there was the Mills Brothers.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
And then Louis Prima and Keeley Smith.
Ooh.
And Mel Torme and George Shearing.
Ah.
Of course, Peggy Lee.
Yeah.
I saw her a couple of times. And you were on that stage. I know it.
Yeah, I got to play a lot of good acts there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Well, you know, that was like the venue in town.
I mean, if you
played the Venetian Room,
mm-hmm.
you were big stuff.
Yeah.
And big stuff you are. And we're just thrilled that you could be here in the studio with us.
Oh, well,
and I get
you.
To ask you these questions because there's a couple of people in town that are younger and they're going to learn something from this show.
Well, they really
will.
Yeah, because I tell audiences that we need music now more than ever.
Yes,
because,
we do.
Because music is spiritual. And, you know, when we're up there playing, we're in kind of an out-of-body experience,
mm-hmm.
and we bring the audience with us.
That's right.
Because, you know, for maybe 2 or 3 hours, the audience is sitting close together, and no one's mad at each other. You know, we bring them with us on stage.
That's right.
And then when they get home, they take that home with them. You know, and I've told them, you know, if you feel yourself into kind of a negative mood or not, you know, whatever.
Yeah, you could have had a bad day or something.
So just think back on that moment and you're happy.
The following show is being brought to you in part by Body Best Collision Center, Myers Financial, Larbre Automotive, Tina Schoen, Broker Associate, Sotheby's International Realty, and Word Mice. Weinberg Deli, located at 997 Napa Road in Sonoma. And Krista Granton Insurance Services, located at 255 West Napa Street. For more information, you can go to KristaGrantonInsurance.com. Broadway Market, a small-town market in the Sonoma wine country, located at 20511 Broadway. You can contact them at 707-935-2685 or visit them on the web at BroadwayMarketSonoma.com. Sonoma Paint Center, located at 815 West Napa Street in Sonoma. For more information, you can go to SonomaPaintCenter.com. Sonoma Chevrolet, located at 687 West Napa Street in Sonoma. For more information, you can go to SonomaChevy.com.
And you know, there are some people watching us tonight on TV who remember this music and love it and remember you and love you. And then there's some people that are watching that they're just experiencing this music for the first time,
that's what I
like is to show people, you know, real music and what it's about. And let's start over. What are you going to play?
Let me see. I've got to think here.
Okay.
Let me see. Keep talking.
I could keep talking. I was going to ask you about your fantasy recording career.
Well, ask me that, what I think.
You want to talk about that right now?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. You played with Vince Guaraldi Trio?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Started with Vince and I and Dean Riley, the bass player.
Yeah.
So we did the first recording, and we stayed with Fantasy up until when he started doing the Peanuts things and the Christmas albums.
Right.
So we got to that point. So that was a good... and then, of course, then I got to record my own music, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
I was going to say that for last.
Yeah, I did. Then Fantasy was sold, and it became the Concord. Concord Jazz. Yeah. So, I don't know, maybe 10 albums for... Could that be 10? Maybe. Yeah.
All right.
For Concord.
Why don't you play something from one of those albums?
I can't remember anything.
Well, then don't.
let me think. Let's see what can you do.
For those of you that don't get your retirement checks and yet, that was Polka Dots and Moonbeams.
Oh, yeah.
I think it was during the Dorsey era that that came out. So, Eddie.
Yes.
You're now living in Sonoma.
Uh-huh.
You're doing gigs in the Bay Area with your wife, Madeline.
Uh-huh.
And I guess life is pretty good. Life is doing okay.
Yeah. Good. Yeah, we do work in the city. We go back and forth. And there's a nice place that we, it's called the Cafe Claude in San Francisco.
Cafe Claude.
Yeah. So, yeah, and the, they're great. I mean, they love the music, and the food is good. Usually it's a duo or trio.
Yeah.
Because whatever the market will bear, you know.
I know.
And, but luckily we can do duos because we've been doing a lot of duos.
Of course.
Know? And sometimes we get to do a trio.
Yeah, we got time for one more song, Eddie. So what do you want to share with us tonight?
Oh, I'm going to do These Foolish Things. Remind me of
Madeline. Well, Eddie, I want to thank you.
Oh.
I want to thank you for
my pleasure.
For doing this little gig with us tonight, because it was really my pleasure to be able to talk to you about your music and your playing. And I know we've done a few gigs together past. The highlight of my career is tonight being able to listen to you and talk to you about your music. It's just been wonderful, and I want to thank you for being here at KSVY live at Studio B.
Yeah.
And thanks again.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Keep swinging.
Keep singing.